There are fears the government may try to change the law to get around a Supreme Court ruling against the controversial Rua Taniwha Dam in Hawke's Bay. The court has agreed with Forest and Bird that the Conservation Minister's attempt to swap protected land in the Ruahine Forest Park for farmland to make way for the dam's reservoir is illegal. Forest and Bird says the decision is a victory for the conservation estate nationwide. But the Minister of Conservation, Maggie Barry, says the government will now look at changing the law to ensure such land swaps can go ahead. Peter Fowler reports.
One of the National Government's key aims is to increase export earnings through more intensive farming, and irrigation dams such as Rua Taniwha are a critical part of the strategy. Out of hundreds of sites the Hawke's Bay Regional Council looked at to build the Rua Taniwha Dam, only one was suitable. But the area it wanted to flood, with about 100 million cubic metres of water behind a 90 metre high dam wall, happened to be protected conservation land, the Ruahine Forest Park. So the Minister of Conservation and the Council did a deal. The protected land would be deregistered and swapped for some nearby farmland, allowing the $900 million project to go ahead. Forest and Bird went to court to challenge the move and won after going all the way to the Supreme Court. Conservation Minister Maggie Barry says the proposed land swap was not illegal. But Ms Barry says the government will now look at changing the law to ensure such deals can take place. She says the Director General of DOC acted in good faith by approving the swap.
We have always made it a principal point for conservation that we swap low for high value conservation land if there are net gains for conservation. So he did what we have been doing for a number of years.
But a Hawke's Bay Regional Councillor, Paul Bailey, says the conservation land being swapped in the Rua Taniwha case is not low-quality conservation land.
Certainly the 22 hectares in question is of high conservation values. That's, you know, originally when DOC submitted on that, they indicated that. I haven't seen the land that they were looking at swapping it with, but I understand it's like just plugged-up paddock with a few bit of regrowth on it.
So would you describe that as high-quality conservation land?
No, I would dispute that assertion completely.
Forest and Bird Chief Executive Kevin Haig says if there is land outside of the conservation estate that has high conservation values, it probably already has some form of protection.
But also B, well, why doesn't the government stand by it or acquire it otherwise to include it in the conservation estate? We don't need to lose specially protected land to be able to acquire other land.
Kevin Haig says Forest and Bird will fight the government every step of the way if it decides to change the law to get around the Supreme Court ruling. Other than the government changing the law, the only other option for the Hawke's Bay Regional Council to build the Rua Taniwha Dam now appears to be seize it under the Public Works Act. In Hawke's Bay for Checkpoint, Peter Fowler.